I did a some bicycle and it's basically a four-wheel mountain bike. So a project. I had design goals to have four wheels, four independent suspensions, and lots of grip for mountain biking and biking in the fall with a lot of leaves on the ground. My coworker was complaining about it, like, I can't go mountain biking all the time in the fall because the leaves, you know, they slip a lot. So I figured with two more wheels, you might get a little longer. So yeah, this is the inspiration. I saw this on the History Channel once, and like, oh, this is an amazing bike. It's a Dodge Tomahawk V10 engine in a motorcycle. So I saw the arms on it, and like, these arms are amazing. Like, I really like the idea. The only thing is, once I got into this project, I realized, oh, it can't turn that well. So I tried to widen it as much as possible to get the turning to work as well. But that was the inspiration there. And here's a little video of how the wheels actually turn and work. And these are the headlights, by the way. I could put them on the bicycle as well, but it scissors kind of. So when you need to turn on a motorcycle, you turn like that, and it works pretty well, actually. So mainly on any kind of bike, yeah, that's mainly how you turn. You don't really turn the wheel a lot unless you're making some really sharp turns, and then you wouldn't be going too fast. But so I wasn't really concerned about the turning aspects of the bike. So turns like that. So there's the design phases, the problem station, design goals, and all the unique functions I have in it, materials for the bike. As you can see, it's basically like a traditional mountain bike frame with this right here, and then a modified kind of rear back. If you look at a regular mountain bike, it's almost the same, plus or minus the two other wheels that I added to it. So in the rear, it has two different suspensions. The is kind of hidden here, I'll show it later. And then in the front, in here and in here, and on each side, there's torsions. There would be torsion springs and dampers that would act to dampen. And here's the animation. I apologize, it goes kind of fast. Is it 360? These are the front tires. I actually spent a lot of time right at this point, and as you can see right in here, these are all engraved right down into the tire. And the way I did this was with surfaces. So I tried to do it, you know, just do a sketch and revolve, cut everything, and that did not work at all because this is a huge curved surface. And because it's a revolve surface, you can't really pattern something like that. So I projected a sketch. Unfortunately, I couldn't draw the chain. But as you'll see later in the animation here, I used a gear connection between the front and the back to actually make it work at a 3-to-1 ratio, so this spins three times and the back wheel spins once. And then according to the pitch diameter of each of these gears. So a chain would go from each side, there would be two chains, one on each side of this gear, and they'd drive each back wheel independently, hence the independent suspensions. And then these pedals were kind of pretty simple. This would all be welded, of course, and it froze again. Awesome. So then the bike seat, I actually measured from an actual mountain bike as well, especially the heights. All the dimensions I try to get as exact as possible to be or not. And the brake calipers as well up here would be big disc brakes and really good stopping power, I guess. Same thing could go on the back, but isn't really necessary. There's different brake designs I was playing with, but I didn't have time to decide on one and go with it. Next is going to be taking it apart. This actually took a while. It's a U-joint. I went to McMaster car and looked up U-joints. As you can see, there's a little ball in there, or not really a ball, it's a square, and this is out there. And that square attaches to two parts. parts in it in terms of just like anything, right? And of course these arms can go up and down as well. I just didn't have time to show it. Here's all the parts, obviously. See these two pin joints, these two pins right here. One is to hold the cable that goes in for just a regular braking system, and the other one is to pinch the other side of the cable so it can squeeze the caliper. And it hinges right here, and I get the pins, and it grows again. But I won't show the animation again. It goes through the pedals and the rear wheel assembly, and it continues from there. So there's the pedals, the materials, rear wheel assembly. Here's the shock, which is the normal damper shock system that comes with any bike you get nowadays. Here's the steering. As I was pointing out earlier, there's this ball hinge that I call it, that acts for the joint. It actually took a long time to figure out, because optimally you would want a ball joint there, but ball joints in Pro's gear have infinite degrees of freedom, so it goes all over the place and it would make a turn. So this was made with two pin joints here and here, and it actually works. So then this attaches to the wheel assembly, and everything turns and works. It's great. So here's my website. Actually have to get out of here to show my user's manual. I don't know why it's doing that right now, but I didn't upload every single picture, but I have a general gist of everything. All my alternate designs as well. Description of the system and my final pictures of the rendered bike. This will go. So that's, I went with traditional chrome. I didn't feel like giving it a crazy paint job. All the treads I had to do with a separate color because it wouldn't stand out otherwise. I tried to apply some cloth material that kind of looked like leather or rubber or something of that nature. It turned out okay. Did the same thing for the seat. Also, got a lot of pictures. This is it turning somewhat. I don't know why it's cut off. But see, it scissors just like in the actual Dodge Yamaha. And the back wheels are, yes, they're straight. But I rendered this photo when I was doing the mechanism. I actually want to show that. I'll just skip the whole animation. There's a front big brick support and all that. And there's my website. And here's a very, very close view of this tire. As you can see, there's little minute details that definitely would cause some failures in other design. So, that's the whole project. Let me show you the video. Here's the wheel chain, so showing 3:1. That's quite short. As you can see, it turns 3 times. One time in terms, and it works. It would go in the front here, but it'll take a while. The front, it already showed an animation that the front wheels can turn and go up and down as well. There's one more thing. Also, a quick thing I wanted to show everybody. As I published this with Pro Engineer 4, you can create four 4D. PDFs where you can actually rotate this, and you can insert this into your PDFs, and it actually does a modeling and rotates. And this is kind of strange. You can actually move around, zoom in and out of different parts.